Good afternoon to one and all. So I am Dr. H. R. Ravisha, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Bangalore University, Bangalore. So today I am presenting a paper on influence of ant fungi and accumulation of phytoplankton in micropropagated plants of Vaitenia somnifera. So then coming to the introduction, so Vaitenia somnifera belongs to the family Solanaceae. It's an understrub, so it grows in so drier part of India and also so subtropical and so northwestern part of India. So it is popularly known as ashwagandha, so Indian ginseng, then winter cherry. So here it is used in the Indian system of medicine as a herbal tonic in the form of medha rasayana. So the roots are rich source of so steroidal so lactones like so vitanoids, vitanones, vitaferin, cytosteroids, alkaloids, flavonins, so etc. The plants are exploited for its various medicinal properties by so pharmaceutical industries and also so herbal practitioners. So therefore, the present study was designed to investigate the effect of ant fungi on enhancement of secondary metabolites in so micropropagated plants. So this is the systematic position of the so the plant Vaitenia somnifera, the division Magnolia phyta. So class Magnoliopsida, order Solanellis, so family Solanaceae, genus Vaitenia, so species Somnifera. So then coming to the objectives, so the first and foremost important is establishment of in vitro culture from so various explants. Here I am selected short tip, so nodal explant and the leaf explants to evaluate the comparative studies between the normal regenerated and the ant fungi treated plants. So third one is so to assess the percent colonization and root fungi spores in the root. So the fourth one is to investigate the antioxidant and the vitanoids. So the last one is to study the potential ant fungal species influencing the amount of secondary metabolites. So is there any need for conservation of this medicinal plant? Yes, there is a need for conservation of this, so especially Vaitenia somnifera. So it is mainly due to the increasing so demand for the herbal products. So if you take an herbal practitioners, so one or the other way they are daily collecting the plant for the preparation of the herbal drugs. The second one is, so already madam told, so an unscientific method of collection. What is unscientific method of collection? See, the herbal practitioners, so here the root contains important vitanoid contents or vitaferin A. So here, so the herbal practitioners so pluck the whole plant for the collection of the root. So automatically once pluck the whole plant, so the plant becomes so disappear from the natural habitat. So this is the unscientific method of collection. Due to unscientific method, automatically the complete plant becomes destroyed. So large amount of metal is required for the preparation of the drugs. So that's why so there is urgent need for the conservation and the cultivation of this plant. So then coming to the material methods, so collection of the plant materials, the seeds and seedlings are collected from the Kolar Hill station in Karnataka. So the seedlings are maintained in the so Botanical Garden, Department of Botany, Bangalore University, Bangalore. So standardization of media, here the different medias are so tried with the different media. Among these, Murashiga and Skoog media is better, so it gives better results so compared to other media. So these are the different growth regulators used for the so tissue culture studies, auxins, cytokinins and gibberellins. Then establishment of the aseptic culture. Here, so the explants are so sterilized with different sterilized like so chlorine water, mercury chloride, sodium hypochlorite, ethanol, etc. So ant fungal studies. So the first of all, the collection, multiplication, maintenance of the glomus species. So the glomus species are collected from the GKVK, University of Agricultural Sciences, Bangalore. So these glomus species are glomus mosaic, glomus fasciculatum, glomus macrocarpum are so multiplied and maintained in the so Department of Botany. So the next step is the experimental design. Once the tissue culture plants are established, I selected into different so experimental setup. Number one is the so control set. So T1 is the normal plant, T2 is the micropropagated plants. These two are as control set. So T3, T4, T5 is the so glomus mosaic, fasciculatum and macrocarpum. Here the plant rises from the shoot tip culture, means shoot tip explants. The same set of experiment, the plants obtained from the nodal culture. So here the plants so rise from the so leaf culture. So in addition to this, so different parameter studies are So percent of root colonization, so spore count, so morphological characters and biomass, so phytochemical studies like so primary metabolites, so chlorophyll content, total carbohydrates, reducing sugars, total proteins, amino acids. Then secondary metabolites like so phenolics, so antioxidant assay by DPPH method and the ABTS method. Then HPL analysis, so quantification of vitafirin A, so according to Rathod et al. 2013. So then coming to the result, so first of all the three different explants are so selected for my research work. So here in the first figure A shows the so induction of callus from the so shoe tip explants. So here the profuse callus is obtained from the so leaf shoe tip explant. The second one is the so the callus obtained from the so nodal explant. So here you can see the so profuse callus, profuse and spongy callus is obtained from the so leaf explants. So MS media supplemented with the 240.5 mg per liter. So in the plate 2, so figure A shows so the combination of so auxins and the so cytokinin. In the earlier, so I used individual auxins. Here, so the combination of IV and the kinetin means auxins and the cytokinins. In the first one, the profuse callus is induced by the IVA 2 mg per liter plus kinetin 0.5 mg per liter. So here, so the stem explant induces callus in IVA 2 mg per liter and BA so 0.5 mg per liter. So this is the so leaf explants cultured on the 240, so 2 mg per liter and the BA 0.5 mg per liter. So this is the table shows the combination of auxins and the cytokinins studied. So here the percentage of, so A is the percent of explants responded, so B is the number of shoots initiated. So here totally there are 15 explants are so inoculated on the so selected for the so percentage of so explant responded and multiplication. Here so BA 2 mg per liter and 240.5 mg per liter shows the so better response compared to that of the so other combinations. Here kinetin also, so the combination of kinetin and 240, kinetin 2 mg per liter, so 240.5 mg per liter shows better response to compared to so other combinations. Here the combination of so BA and the IBA, so here also the same things, BA 2 mg per liter, IBA so 0.5 mg per liter and so kinetin 2 mg per liter, IBA so 0.5 mg per liter shows the so highest amount of percentage of response and also more number of multiple shoots. So this is the figure 1 shows the so number of multiple shoots means initiation of multiple shoots from the so shoot tip explants. So the explants are cultured on the so MS medium supplemented with kinetin 2 mg per liter, IBA 0.5 mg per liter. So figure B shows the so initiation of multiple shoots from the so BA 2 mg per liter, IBA 0.5 mg per liter in nodal explants. So here also the initiation of multiple shoots from the leaf explants. So the leaf explants are supplemented with the MS medium, so supplemented with BA 1 mg per liter and 240, so 0.5 mg per liter. So the table 3 represents the so combination of so cytokinins, the multiple shoots obtained from the combination of cytokinins, so BA and the so kinetin and kinetin and the BA, so vice versa. So here also so the BA 2 mg per liter and kinetin so 0.5 mg per liter. So in leaf explant also BA so 2 mg per liter and kinetin 0.5 mg per liter shows the better response so compared to that of the other so concentrations. So here you can see the so the multiplication of multiple shoots from the so shoot tip explant. So this is the nodal explant, so this one is the so leaf explants. So after the once the so multiple shoots are so developed, the multiple shoots are transferred to the rooting media. So here the insertion of rooting in the charcoal media containing MS media supplemented with so IBA 0.5 mg per liter. So here you can see the complete regenerated shoot and the root, so MS media supplemented with IBA 1 mg per liter. So after the so development of root and shoot, so the complete plant is transferred from tissue culture bottle to so nursery trays, the nursery trays containing the sterilized coconut peat moss. So then so after so 10 or 15 days, so again these are transferred to the so pot mixture containing sterile soil, manure and the sand in the ratio of 1:1 1. So these are the plants maintained in the subpart conditions. So these are the complete regenerated plants. So T1, T2 are the control set in all the three experiments. So these three are the glomus treated plants. So the first set is the the plants obtained from the shoe tip culture. The second set is the plants obtained from the nodal culture. The plants obtained from the figure C is the plant obtained from the leaf culture. So after that, the plants are subjected to the percent of root colonization. So here also in the T1 and T2 in control set we are used the sterilized soil. There is no root colonizations or there is no vesicles or vesicles or the spores. So here you can see the T5, T7 and the T10. So means T4, T7 and T10 shows the highest number of vesicles or vesicles and the spores. Means glomus fasciculatum treated plant shows the better highest number of vesicles and the R vesicles. So in the figure ABC shows the presence of vesicles. So the D and D shows the presence of R vesicles. So here influence of glomus species on the biomass production, fresh weight and the dry weight. So here also the fresh weight and dry weight. So in the glomus species, treated plant shows the highest amount of fresh weight and dry weight compared to that of the other treated and the control plants. So this is the plant obtained from the shoe tip. So in the here the nodal plants, glomus fasciculatum treated plant shows the almost highest biomass productions, means fresh weight and the dry weight. So this is the leaf explants. So here in both glomus fasciculatum and the glomus mass treated plant shows the better response or the highest amount of biomass productions from the leaf explants. So then coming to the phytochemical studies, the number one is estimation of chlorophyll. So the estimation of chlorophyll is conducted to all the three set of experiments. So here the glomus treated plants T4, T7 and T10. So these are the glomus treated plants shows the higher content of chlorophyll compared to that of the other treated plant. So table 9 represents the estimation of carbohydrates. Here also glomus treated plants shows the highest amount of carbohydrate content compared to that of the other treated and the control plant. So reduction sugars also the same thing. So the glomus treated plant shows the better response compared to other treated plants. Here the estimation of total proteins. So here T4 means glomus fasciculatum treated plant shows better response compared to that of the other treated and the control plants. So estimation of free amino acid also here. So glomus treated plants shows the highest response later followed by the glomus massae and the glomus macrocarpum for finally the tissue culture plant and the control plant. So phenolic content, these are the secondary metabolites. So the phenolic content is almost the glomus treated plants and the glomus fasciculatum treated plant shows the better response in the root, stem and the leaves. So these are the IC50s means DPPH and the ABTS scavenging activity of the antioxidants. So the first one is the IC50 standard values. These are the T9, T10, T11 are the plants obtained from the leaf cultures. Here there is a significance result is obtained from the glomus fasciculatum treated plants compared to that of the massae and the macrocarpum. So finally, the plant is the roots are collected from the all the experimental setup control plant and the treated plants. So the roots are subjected to the estimation of or extraction of the phytoprene through HPLC techniques. So here you can see the first one is the standard sample. So it shows the 98% of the standard T1, T2 are the control plant. So here T5, T4, T7 and the T10 shows the highest amount of phytoprene A content compared to that of the other treated plants. So these are the standard sample. So this one is the these two are the control plants. So here you can see the T4 is the highest peak compared to that of T3 and T5. Here also T7 and T10 shows the highest peak. So compared to other two species, T7 and the T10 are the so Glomus basculatum treated plants. So then coming to the conclusions, so the induction of callus was better in the so medium supplemented with 2,4-D and the IBA, and also highest number of multiple shoots were observed in the so combinations of cytokinase B and the so carnitine. So shoot tip and nodal experiments were found to be suitable for the indirect organogenesis. So Glomus fasciculatum and Glomus mosaic treated plant so proved to be efficient in terms of root colonization, vesicles and the arbicles. The biomass, primary metabolites and secondary metabolites were significantly enhanced in AM inoculated micropropagated plants. So Vitafirin A content is quantified by HPLC also reviewed. So significant elevation in the so Glomus treated plants, especially so Glomus fasciculatum. So AM fungi treated plants show better antioxidant scavenging activity compared to control plants. The study proves to be beneficial in rapid propagation of medicinally important plants through in vitro organogenesis and further enhancing their metabolites by using AM fungi. Thank you. If you have any doubts.